What's up guys, David here. And like last year, this year, the Galaxy S8 is powered by two different chipsets. If you live in a country like the US or Canada, you're getting an S8 powered by Qualcomm's Snapdragon 835. And if you live almost anywhere else, you're getting Samsung's own Exynos 8895 under the hood. Now, while both of these chips are similar, they're both using Samsung's 10 nanometer process, and both are coupled with 4 gigabytes of RAM, there are some differences. The way the individual cores are configured, the clock speeds of those cores, the GPUs, and even the software may be a little bit different, which begs the question, which one of these phones is faster, or is there even a difference? Well, only one way to find out. Let's get into it. All right, we'll kick things off by starting the stopwatches on each phone and then jump right into the first row of system apps, where the Exynos variant of the S8 gets the step over the Snapdragon variant after the camera app, but only by a fraction of a second. And while the Exynos loads Facebook faster, the Snapdragon variant loads Snapchat faster, so both phones are now neck and neck in Photoshop, and it'll be interesting to see what happens next in lapses, where both CPUs will be put to the test. So we'll pay attention to the rate at which each phone completes processing this time lapse, where it looks like the Exynos variant completed it at a faster rate, improving on its lead as both phones move on to Subway Surfers. But the lead the Exynos variant has over the Snapdragon variant is a small one, so we'll see if we can create some separation here in Subway Surfers. And no, it's actually the opposite, with the Snapdragon variant loading the game faster, putting it right back into this thing. So neither phone has been able to create any kind of real separation thus far, but there is still a few more apps left to go here in this first lap, with the entire second lap remaining, where last year with the Galaxy S7, the Exynos variant had the advantage. Speaking of which, it looks like the Exynos variant has pulled ahead here in Crossy Road, recapturing the lead once again and already moving on to Bullet Force, which by the way, quick shout out to everybody who recommended using this game on Twitter. So we're loading the offline practice mode here in Bullet Force, where once again, it looks like the Exynos variant of the Galaxy S8 finished at a faster rate, giving it the biggest lead it's had so far in this speed test. Now, before we get into the second lap, I want to let you guys know about a pretty big change in the way the second lap will be performed. In the past, we started the second lap from the top and worked our way back down, whereas from now on, we'll be starting from the bottom and working our way back up, which will help provide more accurate results. So there you go, the Exynos finished the first lap with a time of 1 minute and 41 seconds, and the Snapdragon variant finished just 4 seconds later with a time of 1 minute and 45 seconds, so not much of a difference there. Of course, the big question is, how will each do in terms of RAM management? So the Exynos variant fails to keep Subway Surfers open. Let's see if the Snapdragon could, and no, it has to reload the game as well. Now, the Snapdragon variant did load Subway Surfers at a faster rate in the first lap, as I expected to do here in the second, so it should be able to close in on the Exynos variant's lead. But to be honest, unless one of these phones has more apps stored in RAM than the other, I don't think there'll be much of a difference, and so far, that certainly seems to be the case. They're pretty much going toe-to-toe in the second lap as they were in the first lap, with the Exynos variant finishing just 2 seconds ahead of the Snapdragon variant, which to me, anything less than 3 seconds is below the margin of error, so I'm gonna have to call this one a tie. Taking a look at the individual app load-up times from the first lap, you can see where one phone did better in one app, the other phone did better in another app. So don't worry, your Galaxy S8 performs roughly the same as the next guy's, which is something you can't really say if you have a Galaxy S7. Anyways, that is it for me in this video. Thank you guys for watching, and as always, I'll see you in the very next episode.